Hi, I'm Rudraya, a senior lecturer from BFUC. Welcome to the new session. In this session, we are going to discuss about a linear programming problem. The very basically, LPP, expanded as a linear programming problem, it is one of the part of operation research. In a previous session, we come across with what is the scope of operation research, what are the significance, and what are the uses, and what are its scope. And as a part of this session, I'm going to give a brief introduction about the LPP and its significance and how it is utilized and how it is working in our current scenario. Coming to the LPP, so first of all, what is LPP? Why we require? I'll give an example. We have an organization or industry where we are going to employ many things like many materials, raw materials, human resource, cost, time, all these things are considered as a constraints. Whenever we have a many constraints, so it is going to be utilized in a judicious way. Like when we have a resources in a limited quantity, the question arises, how do we are going to utilize this limited resources in an effective way so as to obtain a maximum profit or maximum yield? So LPP basically deals with the maximization or minimization of a given objective function. Now, as part of definition, a general LPP deals with the optimization of a linear function of variables which may be cost or profit subject to a set of constraints, that is demand, labor, etc. LPP is a mathematical technique for determining an optimal allocation of the limited resources to meet a given objective. As I told already, all LPP problem will be considered to maximize a profit or minimize a cost. So basically, we have only two objective functions, either it is maximize or minimize. A programming means planning, which refers to the process of determining a particular plan of action from amongst the several alternatives, and a word linear means all the variables in the model are linear. So coming to any particular problem in our daily life, let us, it is an organization, or it may be a business, or it may be school, education institution, or any sector. In every sector or in every field, there arises objective. So we need to define some of the variables which we are going to utilize in our daily life. So the resources whichever it is going to employ will be utilized in an effective way or a judicial way. So for that, we need to practice a linear programming problem. I mean, LPP is going to use to get a maximize or minimize of a objective function. Generally, LPP will be either maximization or minimization of a given objective function with given inequality constraints and non-negative restrictions. So any problem which is available in our daily life, it will be converted into mathematical model. So along with the constraints. Constraint means the restriction or limitations. So within that particular limitation, how we are going to obtain our objective function, and with the limited resources, how we are going to get a maximized yield or a minimization of a cost, all these things will be related in the LPP. When a profit is concerned, it has to be maximized. When it is a loss, labor, cost, raw materials, it has to be minimized. So in general, we have only two types of objective function. So when it is profit, obviously profit, everybody wants to get a more profit or more yield. So whenever your problem is concerned with the profit, it has to be maximized. That means you can clearly identify the objective function as a maximization when it is given profit. And similarly, when it is a loss, nobody wants to get huge loss. Always they wanted to minimize the loss. So it is a minimization. That means when you have a loss, it has to be minimized. Labor, once again, using with a limited number of labors, how to carry our work in a maximum way. And cost, of course, the investment, with a limited investment or with a less investment, getting a more profit is, of course, it's an objective function. And raw materials also should be utilized in a minimum way to get the maximized yield. So this is all about the LPP. In the next session, we are going to learn about a general formula of LPP and how to convert a real life LPP problem into mathematical model.